A warm October evening was the perfect time for a conversation with a friend. So two good friends, George and Samuel, decided to go to a cozy cafe located on the corner of the street. The friends sat down at an empty table, joking around and having fun. Then, having read the menu that was on the table, the young people made their choices. Since the order was taken by a beautiful young waitress, the guys couldn't help but check her out, unable to keep their eyes off the beautiful woman. George looked at Samuel in surprise, who raised his thumb up approvingly. The woman's name was Claire. The guys got this information off the badge attached to her snow-white uniform. Samuel ordered a slice of apple pie and coffee, but George was hungry, so he ordered a couple of mouth-watering burgers. The whole time the two friends spent at the cafe, George didn't take his eyes off the beautiful waitress, and she smiled sweetly at him from time to time. "Forget it, friend. Trust me, this girl doesn't need you at all. She's probably after your money, and if you don't have a fat wallet, this beauty won't even look in your direction," Samuel said confidently after he intercepted his friend's glance and understood everything without words. The two men had been friends since school, and Samuel knew that George was the son of a successful businessman with a multi-million dollar fortune. Usually, the handsome rich man listened to what his friend had to say, but this time, his words about a complete stranger seemed unjustified to him. When the men were already full and were all talked out, George took out his wallet and paid for the dinner. Then he called a cab and dropped his friend off at his house before returning to his parents' luxurious home. George could hardly sleep that night. Tossing and turning in bed, he kept thinking about what Samuel had said. George simply couldn't believe that the sweet woman from the cafe could turn out to be a gold digger. This thought haunted him for several days until he finally decided to make his own conclusions. Since George worked at his father's firm, he didn't have to adhere to a strict schedule and could manage his time as he pleased. Therefore, taking advantage of this situation, the young man began to implement the plan that he had developed the night before. Thus, George bought an old gardener's jacket at a garage sale and even threw it on the ground and stepped on it a few times. Then he pulled out worn work boots and ripped jeans from the shelf. Without hesitating for a second, George put on these old clothes. He looked in the mirror and was happy to see a reflection of a battered tramp looking back at him. The man completed his image with a 3-day stubble, which made him look like a slum dweller. "Well, that's better," said George and winked at his reflection in the mirror. Not the least bit embarrassed by his appearance, the man went straight to the very cafe where he had dinner with Samuel not that long ago. There, sitting at a table in the corner, George ordered a cup of coffee, observing the reaction of the young waitress. To the man's surprise, Claire acted as if he weren't a beggar, but a regular customer, just like everyone else. "What would you like?" the waitress asked, smiling sweetly at the visitor. "What can I get for this amount?" George asked, embarrassed, and pulled out a handful of change from his pocket. Claire nodded understandingly and brought the man a cup of coffee and a cheese sandwich. But George didn't come to the cafe to have breakfast, so he plucked up his courage and asked, "Can I invite you for a walk with me in the park tonight?" Claire laughed at his audacity, but George was very persuasive, so the young woman quickly agreed. "Great, ice cream and a great mood are on me," said the man, continuing to eat his sandwich. This caused Claire to burst into joyful laughter, which George took as a good sign. "Okay then, wait for me at the entrance of the park at 7 p.m. The woman said goodbye and went to serve the client at the next table. George finished his coffee, and leaving his sandwich half-eaten, went out into the street. Later that day, he went to the park to meet Claire at the entrance. She was 10 minutes late, causing George to worry a bit. But when the girl apologized for her tardiness, the man relaxed and went to the ice cream booth. Eating the delicious ice cream, the young people walked along the lantern-lit alleys of the park and talked about many things. Continuing to pretend he was poor, George said that he worked as a loader in a hardware store. Then, seeing how Claire tensed up, he asked her to tell him a little bit about herself. Sighing sadly, Claire revealed that she worked as a waitress out of despair. As it turned out, her parents were very poor, and her dad was sick often, which is why the family was in a very difficult financial situation. The young people chatted more about other things, not even noticing how late it's gotten. George took Claire home, and then stood by the woman's house for a long time, looking dreamily at the starry sky. This walk in the park marked the beginning of their relationship. George and Claire started seeing each other every day, taking walks in the park and going to the movies and cafes. Unbeknownst to themselves, the young people became very close, both emotionally and physically, spending their nights in cheap motels. One day, George invited Claire to go camping with him, promising to show her a special place. Claire was happy to agree, especially since the weather was warm. As it turned out, George organized a trip to the lake, which was located outside the city. The place turned out to be very beautiful. It was hard not to admire the smooth surface of the blue water. "Shall we take a boat ride?" George suggested, heading to the makeshift pier. Claire was happy to. She got into the boat and instantly felt like a brave navigator. George skillfully worked the oars, taking Claire to places where she could admire flocks of graceful swans and wild ducks. Looking towards the shore, Claire suddenly saw a dark SUV parked at the pier. She soon saw a man get out of it. He opened the trunk and took out a black garbage bag. Looking around furtively, the stranger threw it into the water. For some unknown reason, Claire felt very anxious and asked George to get them to the shore, to the place where the man had thrown the bag. When the young people got closer, the bag almost got submerged into the water. George managed to grab the bag, soaking the sleeve of his jacket while doing it. "Look, the bag is moving," he said surprised as he dragged it onto the boat. Without saying a word, Claire untied the knot, and the young people saw three puppies floundering at the bottom of the bag. They couldn't have been older than 1 month. "What kind of monster do you have to be to get rid of puppies this way?" Claire asked indignantly, taking the puppies into her arms. Two of them were brown, and one was black. George had nothing to say about it, since the man loved animals and therefore considered it unacceptable to abuse them. Subsequently, Claire took two puppies to an animal shelter and took the black one home to live with her. The woman named the puppy Smokey and surrounded it with love and care. Claire's noble deed caused a wave of tenderness and respect in George's soul, once again convincing him of the correctness of his choice. One day, George ran into Samuel at the entrance of the cafe. He hadn't seen him for over a week. The friend appreciated George's change of wardrobe and then asked derisively, "So that's what dating a waitress leads to. You'll soon turn into a real tramp." George reacted rather emotionally to his friend's verbal attack, and it almost ended in a fistfight. The next morning, Samuel went to see George's father at his office, telling him in every detail what he had seen the day before. It's hard to say why the man did it. Perhaps it was out of genuine concern for his friend's future, or maybe he was simply being mean. Whatever the case may be, George had a serious conversation with his father that night. "Son, why are you dating that beggar woman? Do you want our family to lose all of our money? Remember, I won't accept her into our family. And if you don't get your act together, I'll write you out of my will," Mr. Adams said, irritated. However, to the man's surprise, this time his son showed persistence and said that he does not need the inheritance of the family wealth. After that, George quickly packed up his things and went to see Claire. He already knew what he had to do, and when the woman opened the door, he told the whole truth about who he was and his family, right there in the doorway. Then, looking into Claire's eyes, the man went down on one knee and asked her to marry him. Claire's face lit up with a sweet smile, and then she softly whispered into George's ear, "I will marry you, darling, but I also have some pleasant news for you." George looked inquiringly at Claire, who was smiling mysteriously, and then told him that she was pregnant. Needless to say, George took this news very emotionally. He immediately felt an increased responsibility and anxiety about their future together. The man understood that having lost the support of his parents, his life would be a lot more difficult now. Of course, George wasn't actually scared, but a shadow of anxiety could still be seen on his face. Claire understood everything without words and smiled as she invited her now fiancé to meet her parents. George gave her a distracted nod. His mind was full of thoughts about where he could find a high-paying job to provide for his wife and unborn child. Therefore, he didn't even notice when the cab driver took them to the address Claire said. It was only when George got out of the car that he froze in surprise, looking at the luxurious two-story mansion in the elite district of the city. "Well, yes, dear. As you can see, you're not the only one who can pretend to be someone else and play dress-up. I saw right through you anyway. I knew you had rich parents," Claire said, intercepting the man's questioning look. As it turned out, she worked as a waitress in the cafe, which, like many establishments in the city, belonged to her father, Charles Baker. Claire's parents turned out to be very wealthy people. Having given their daughter's fiancé a warm welcome, they helped the young people plan their wedding. Later, Mr. Baker hired his son-in-law for the position of a manager in his restaurant business. And 9 months later, the newlyweds welcomed baby Molly into this world, which only made the Baker and Adams families even closer. George's parents had long forgiven their son, and even if Claire was from a poor family, they would have accepted her as their own daughter. Rejoicing at their little granddaughter, both Claire's and George's parents were extremely happy and couldn't help hinting at the young couple that they definitely wouldn't mind having another grandchild. The proud grandparents just wanted to make sure there was enough happiness to go around.